In that tutorial, you are going to create an application to read NFC tags and cards on Android. NFC is the abbreviation for Near Field Communication. It is an international standard for contactless exchange of data in very small range with a maximum distance of 10 cm between two devices. The specifications of NFC are made by the NFC Forum, a consortium of 170 companies and members including MasterCard, Nokia, Samsung, or still Google. The Android SDK offers the support to read NFC tags and cards in standard. We are going to use it in the tutorial. First, we need to add NFC permissions in the Android manifest. We also define that our application will use the NFC feature. It is useful to hide such application from devices having no NFC support on the Play Store, for example. To parse the data read from an NFC tag, we are going to use some classes created by Google for the Android open source project in demos showing how to use NFC. So in a record package, we have the following classes: parsed NDEF record interface, exposing the str method returning the string data read from the NFC card. Then we have three implementations. One for URF record implementing the str method and offering an isuri method letting you to know if data read from an NFC card or tag can be considered as an URI. Another for text record based on the same principle. Another for smart poster which combines an URI and a text. These classes will be essential if you plan to create an application to read content from NFC tags and cards. We'll also use an NDEF message parser class to parse NDEF message read from an NFC card or tag via a static parse method. Note that the getRecords method will take in parameter an array and NDEF record objects, and then we iterate on each record to parse it into a parse NDEF record object. Now we can create a simple user interface with an image view representing the logo of the SORL mobile application and also a text view to display the data read from the NFC card or tag. We center the text view horizontally. We add the text, all the tag against the back of your device. We set the text style and the text size to 20 sp. Then we define the margin left, margin right, and the margin top. The gravity is defined to center horizontal. And then we place the text view just below the logo. Now it's time to write the Java code of the main activity. Like previously, we will use in this activity some methods offered by Google for the Android open source project. So the dump data tag taking a tag in parameter and returning the data dumped from this tag in string format. To x, to reverse x to deck, and to reverse deck, utilitarize static methods letting to print bytes data to the decimal or decimal format. Then we can define some properties in the main activity. One property for the NFC adapter object, another for the pending intent, and the last for the text view, used to display the data read from the NFC card or tag. In the onCreate method, we get the reference from the text view. Then we get the default NFC adapter by calling the getDefaultAdapter static method of the NFC adapter object. If the NFC adapter returned is null, we display a toast to the user and we finish the current activity. Otherwise, we can create a pending intent pointing to the current activity. We create the pending intent pointing to the current activity with an intent and we add the flags to this intent. In the onResume method, we check if the NFC is enabled and by calling the isEnabled method on the NFC adapter instance. If it is the case, we display the wireless settings screen. For that, we need to define the showWirelessSettings method. We create an intent pointing to the wireless settings screen. For that, we add an action, action wireless settings in the intent. And then we can start the activity with this intent. We display a toast to the user. To alert him, we redirect him in the action wireless settings screen. Now we can return in the onResume method and we call the enable foreground dispatcher method on the NFC adapter instance with the pending intent created previously. In the onPause method, we don't forget to disable the NFC adapter by calling the disable foreground dispatch method. Then we override the onNewIntent method, which will be called when the NFC cell will detect NFC card or tag. Inside this method, we set the intent and we call the resolveIntent method by passing this intent in parameter. Now we can define the content of the resolveIntent method. First, we get the action present in this intent. If the action received is action tag discovered, action tag discovered, or action NDF discovered, we get the data contained in the intent. For that, we call the getParcelableArrayExtra method on the intent with the extra NDEF messages constant in parameter. If extra NDEF messages is not null, we create NDEF message object from this data. Otherwise, we try to get data from extra ID content from the intent by calling the getByteArrayExtra method. We get also the tag object. Then we call the dump data tag data method with this tag instance in parameter. Then we create an ENDEF record with the payload read. With this ENDEF record, we create an ENDEF message instance. Finally, at the end of the method, we call the displayMessages method with the NDEF message built previously. In this displayMessages method, we parse the first message in the list. Then we iterate on the parse NDF record got. For each record, we call the str method to get the content in string format. The last step is to display the data read in the text view. Now it's time to try our NFC reader application built with Android Studio. To try this application, we will deploy it on a real device. To watch the demo video, you can click on the link appearing at the end of this video. That's all for that tutorial. To discover more tutorials on Android development, don't hesitate to subscribe to the SORL channel. If you want to contribute to the channel, you can also send me an email with your ideas.